Next part we have 2 by 3 raised to power 3. So we'll do it 2 upon 3 raised to power 3. That can be done as 2 by 3 multiplied with itself 3 times as its power is indicating. So 2 into 2 into 2 divided with 3 into 3 into 3. You get 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8 upon 3 3s are 9, 9 3s are 27. So 8 by 27 is the answer. Moving to the second question, that is writing minus 20 by 7 minus 27 in the exponential form. Now minus 27 can be written in exponential form only when we take out its factors, right? So we get the factors of minus 27 as minus 3 into 3 into 3. So this can be written down as minus 3 raised to power 3. Yes, because even if you check minus 3 multiplied with 3 times with itself, you would get the sign as negative only. That is why earlier I had written the negative sign separately and now I have included it inside. And so we get minus 3 raised to power 3 as the exponential form for minus 27. Next is question number 3, in which we have to simplify these values. For simplification, we have 6 raised to power 8 divided with 6 raised to power 5. Now here the bases are same and they're getting divided. So we have to apply the second law, that was m minus n, that is the powers get subtracted. So we get 6 raised to power 8 minus 5, which gives us 6 raised to power 3. You can solve it further with 6 into 6 into 6. 6 6 are 36 and 36 6 is 6 6 are 36, 3 6 is 18, 19, 20, 21. So you get 216 as the answer for first part. The second part is telling us to simplify 5 raised to power 2, whole raised to power 3 and whole raised to power 4. Now as I discussed with you in the third law, the powers in this case gets multiplied. So first of all, we are going to multiply the power 4 with power 3. So we get 5 raised to power 2 raised to power 3 into 4. That gives you 5 raised to power 2 into 3 4s are 12. Again, that law can be applied and you get 5 raised to power 2 into 12. So 5 raised to power 2 into 12 gives you 5 raised to power 24. Now when you have such big values, you can leave the answer as it is. Please do not go multiplying 5 24 times. That would take lot of time. So you can leave the answer even in exponential form. It will not make any difference. Now the last part is 4 raised to power minus 3 multiplied with 5 raised to power 2 whole divided with 3 raised to power 2. Now over here we have to convert the powers, the negative powers into positive ones, right? Based on the seventh law that I discussed, negative power can be converted into positive power by writing the reciprocal. So if you write the reciprocal for 4 by 3, that would be 1 upon 4 raised to power 3 multiplied with 5 raised to power 2, and this whole is divided with 3 raised to power 2. So first of all, let us solve the brackets. 5 raised to power 2 means 5 into 5 divided with 4 raised to power 3 means 4 into 4 into 4 divided with 3 raised to power 2. Now we are going to multiply. 25 minus 4 4s are 16, 16 4s are 64 divided with 3 raised to power 2. 3 raised to power 2 can be written as 9. Now we have to divide them. So 25 upon 64 multiplied with 1 upon 9, because 9 becomes the reciprocal. So you get 25 multiplied divided with 64 into 9. Let us do that. 64 into 9 gives us 9 4s are 36 and 3. 9 6s are 54. 55, 56, 57. So you get 25 upon 576 as the answer for this one, because here we have solved it. 25 into 1 becomes 25. 64 into 9 becomes 576. Again, I am revising the steps followed here. We have converted this into the reciprocal, that is 1 by 4 raised to power 3 into 5 raised to power 2 remains the same, and it remains in the brackets, divided with 3 raised to power 2. Now here 5 raised to power 2 and 1 gets multiplied, so you get 5 raised to power 2. I have written that as 5 into 5, And in the denominator, I've written it as 4 into 4 into 4 divided with 3 raised to power 2. In the next step, I have multiplied and got the fraction as 25 over 64 divided with 3 square, that is 9. Now 25 upon 64 multiplied with the reciprocal, because the division has converted into multiplication. So here we are converting the 9 into its reciprocal, that will be 1 by 9. And you multiply numerator with numerator and denominator with denominator, you would get 25 ones as 25 and 64 nines as 576. So this remains the answer for the last simplification sum. This is how you can apply the laws of exponents and solve the questions.